This is Customer Success Innovation, Episode 1. The latest innovation in customer success, we call it Outcome Success Plans. Outcome Success Plan is relevant more than ever today. We are kind of in this day and time where, you know, coronavirus is spreading. The next few months, we will need to ensure business continuity and that our customers are getting value from our products and services, but that will have to rely more heavily on digital means. So being able to digitize more of the relationship with the customer, being able to rely more on digital technology and automation to actually deliver, to ensure business continuity and even deliver higher value of experiences to your customers is relevant today more than ever. So if you are wondering whether you should, you know, double down on technology that works for you and double down on digital versus relying on a more traditional people-centric approach to customer relationship, I think, you know, the world is showing that we have no other option. We have to adopt a digital-enabled customer success model with technology that enables people to do the work remotely, communicate with customers through digital means, have collaboration frameworks that are designed to make the collaboration seamless as you go through your day-to-day. We all know that in customer success, the key is to make sure that your customer is getting value from your products and services. In some cases, you may want to document what is the exact value the customer is expecting and what is the value you're actually delivering, and come up with a plan that is shared with you and your customers. Up until now, the way to do it used to be to document this in a presentation or a set of emails between you and the customer. The problem with all this asynchronous communication is that once you had the meeting with a customer, finished documenting the agreement of what are we trying to do, what are we going to do together, and, you know, and how we're going to do it, it becomes stale immediately, because we know life changes and things are starting to move forward, and 3 months in, we don't have a good recording of what was documented and what is the current status and what has changed and so forth. So Outcome Success Plan is basically a way to document a mutual agreement between you and your customer of what the value is and continuously track it in real time and share the exact same plan, both from the customer and the customer success side and the company side, and also from the customer side. And every change is automatically being reflected in this Outcome Success Plan. Let me give you an example. In some cases, when it comes to onboarding and implementation, some products and services, the implementation could take multiple months. Could be, you know, 3 months. If we're talking about, for example, financial system that is being implemented or ERP system, sometimes it takes more than, it takes a little bit longer than a few days, which could be the case in simpler products and simpler use cases. So the reason why a company would buy an ERP, as an example, is to optimize its supply chain operating model. But when it comes to implementing ERP, there's a lot of steps and activities that needs to be done, which are drivers to the strategic value of improving supply chain cost management and so forth. So we want to be able to capture the objectives and then put the plan for onboarding and make sure that these are being maintained. And the definition of success is not only being able to complete the activities or the deliverables, but also being able to meet the customer expectations. And because it's a little bit multi-tiered, and it's thinking the objective and then the deliverables and the activities, we want to be able to document all that and make sure that this documentation is available both for the implementer and also for the customer. And if there are dependencies there or the or status updates, they are in real time being provided, meaning that there's one part of the technology into Tango would go to the account profile, into the plan, and document the actual status of the plan, of the objective. But at the same time, the customer can log in into the customer portal and to see the status from their end and being able to know what's going on. They can even collaborate and discuss changes in the plan, or you can even the company side from the customer success technology can task the customer, and the customer can complete the task, and all of that is being documented in the technology. So basically what it does, it allows an onboarding to be fully in sync both ends of the relationship. In other cases, companies might invest in relationship for strategic reasons. So they would sign up a contract for 3 to 5 years that would want to reflect a long-term strategy. For example, a company would partner with a vendor for a digital transformation project that could take more than 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. They've done this with strategic objectives, and these strategic objectives have to be documented, and then the plan needs to be aligned with that. So much like when we run our companies, we do usually something like OKR, objectives or key results, to create alignment from top to bottom, or you know, if you're on the Salesforce camp, they call it V2 MOM, but basically creating a full alignment of what is the execution model against the strategic objectives. The same way here, when your customer implements your technology, it could be technology or a set of services, and it could be for multiple years, the customer expects that the implementation is gonna result in the value that was agreed upon in the beginning. Could be hard numbers like top line numbers or bottom line numbers, top line numbers like revenue, ARR growth, bottom line numbers, efficiency metrics, and customer satisfaction, or could be something else. But the activities needs to support that. So being able to document and have, you know, constant clear status update that is available both for the customer and for the company also helps in communicating across the organization. If you need to pull more people into this project, they need to know why they're coming in and what's the objective. If your customer and team on your customers need to communicate the status up or aside, they can clearly define the relationship between what is being done and how does it drive the strategic objective of the investment that has been put in place. And making sure that the value is articulated clearly, and also the status of the delivery of the value is available for both ends, makes the alignment between the receiving end, the providing end, and across all the tiers in such a way that, you know, the focus is on delivering the value and not on trying to figure out where's the documentation and what's the status and so forth. So this is a very powerful capability that we've been asked to build by some of our largest customers, and we are very happy with introducing this to the market. The best way to get started with Outcome Success Plan is just, you know, go on to tango.com and get started with the product. It's available online. If you are a young company or young initiative, less than 5 people, you have the community, which is free forever. So just go to the community edition, create your own account, and get started. If you are one of our amazing Tutango customers, this is available for you today without any additional cost. And if you're an enterprise company that is trying to get started with customer success, whether you're using spreadsheets or other technologies that are not suited for the job, we also have an enterprise trial that you can get started. So just jump on to tango.com and check it out.